Welcome to the Academy of Useless Ideas, where we believe that mathematics becomes even more fascinating when we explore not just its technical side, but its philosophical depths. Today we are diving into the concept of functions, though not through a precise definition, but through a more fuzzy and philosophical lens. Whether you are a seasoned mathematician or just a math enthusiast, take a moment before we continue to reflect on what a function means to you and how you arrived at that definition. If you're up for it, we'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments or on Discord. Sometimes, once we grasp a concept, we forget how we originally learned it. So let's take a trip down memory lane and see how Slim's understanding of functions evolved from a fuzzy idea to a formal definition. Imagine Slim as a bright and curious child excitedly discovering functions for the first time when his math professor introduced linear equations. Picture Slim's delight when he realized that in an equation like y equals 3x plus 1, plugging in a value for x yields a single predictable y. As Slim continued his studies, he encountered a variety of functions, polynomials, trigonometric functions, exponentials, and logarithms. Even though he didn't have a formal definition, the concept of a function seemed pretty straightforward. To Slim, a function was simply a mathematical expression where you input a number for the independent variable and get a corresponding output for the dependent variable. What do you think of this fuzzy definition of a function? Have you ever thought about functions this way? Do you see any issues with this perspective? In his youth, Slim was more intrigued by the practical uses of mathematics than by its abstract concepts. He focused on solving problems rather than understanding the precise definition of a function. Consequently, when he finally encountered a formal definition, he didn't dwell on it. Do you remember your first encounter with the formal definition of a function? What was that definition, and how did you feel about it? Slim's professor defined a function from a set A to a set B as a mathematical object that assigns each element of A to a unique element of B. While this matched Slim's intuitive understanding, there was a key difference. Slim viewed functions through the lens of the calculation process, while the professor's definition abstracted away the specifics of calculation. According to the professor, a function simply needed to ensure that every element in A maps to a value in B, without regard of how those values were computed. Do you see any advantages to abstracting away the calculation process of a function? Any disadvantages? Abstracting away from the calculation of a function can be very useful, especially when the calculation process itself is irrelevant. For example, we can discuss the concept of continuity without concerning ourselves with the specifics of how a function is calculated. Consider the Dirichlet function, dx, which is defined as 1 when x is rational and 0 when x is irrational. Calculating dx might seem straightforward, but try determining its value for x equal to pi to the power of e. However, despite the complexity of such calculations, we don't need to compute the function to know that it is discontinuous everywhere. On the flip side, abstracting the calculation of functions can distance us from reality. Do functions that can't be calculated actually exist? And if they do, in what sense do they exist? Young Slim didn't ponder these questions for long. He accepted the definition of a function without wondering if they were just mathematical fantasies. So, have you ever considered this question? What are your thoughts? If functions exist, in what sense do they exist? Or are they merely imaginative constructs, like majestic unicorns, that exist only in our minds? As with most philosophical questions, there isn't a definitive answer. Instead, we must become comfortable with the ambiguity and take a rational stand. Here we present two possible perspectives. On one hand, you might believe that sets exist in a Platonic realm, and thus functions have a real existence. On the other hand, you might view functions as useful but ultimately fictional constructs that help us make sense of real-world phenomena. Which of these perspectives resonates more with you? Do you have a different view on the existence of functions? How does your belief shape your approach to mathematics? And does this question matter to you? Here at the Academy of Useless Ideas, we love hearing your thoughts on these topics. So don't be shy. Let us know if you find the questions in this video thought-provoking or irrelevant.